as we think of the distress on every hand, what a great thing it is to open up the Word of God and hear the Lord Jesus say, "Come to me, all of you who are tired of carrying your heavy loads, I'll give you rest." He says to us, "I have a peace not like the world gives." And in the midst of all this distress, we find a still point, we find a quiet spot, we find a place of safety and security, of rest and satisfaction in the Lord Jesus. I was just a little boy when I came to realize, and it was a shocking discovery to me, that I was personally responsible for the death of the Lord Jesus. It was my sin that took him there. And as a little fellow, I realized that even though my parents had trained me in spiritual things, that I needed a personal relationship with him. I needed to acknowledge my sin and receive him as my Savior. And as I look back on that day, my simple childlike faith, I didn't understand a lot of things, but I did know this, that I was a sinner, and Christ was the Savior of sinners. And if I put my trust in him, he'd save me. And that's what happened. And these 50 years that I have been on the road to heaven, I found him to be everything I needed. I found him to be my best friend, to be a present help, a very present help in every need. And so, if you're here tonight with a heavy heart, with uncertainty about the future, if you're here tonight with a load of sin and your conscience is inflamed, if you're here and you've tried your best, you've tried through religion, perhaps, or through your own efforts, somehow to find peace with God, and you can't find it, let me highly recommend the Lord Jesus to you, to receive simply as a gift. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So says the Scripture, it's not something that we have to do ourselves. You don't have to climb up to heaven, says Paul, to bring Christ down. You don't have to go in the grave to bring Christ up. But what does the Bible say? The word is near you, even in your mouth and in your heart. In other words, God has put the truth, the word, right on the tip of your tongue. All you have to do is spit it out. All you have to do is say, "Lord, you're right. I am a sinner. I'm the sinner that Jesus died to save. And I want him to save me now. I want to know my sins forgiven. I want to know heaven is my home." And everyone who puts their trust in him finds out that it's true. This offer of the gospel, it works every time. It works every time. There's never been an exception.